A caesarean section is where we deliver the baby through the abdominal wound rather than vaginally. Emergency caesarean section is where it wasn't planned, but it's done because the baby is distressed in labour or because maybe the baby's too big and gets stuck and can't be delivered normally.
You can find a medical reason for anything. Whether or not it's a good medical reason is the question. And a lot of these kind of pseudo reasons are being used to argue women into caesarean sections.
The World Health Organization recommends caesarean sections should only be performed when medically necessary, and rates should be no more than 10 to 15%. In Australia, currently 32% of all births are being delivered through caesarean section, nearly doubling since 1991. In comparison to other countries such as Brazil, France and New Zealand, Australia has one of the highest rates in the world.
The reasons why the caesarean section rate have gone up are pretty obvious and straightforward. There is certainly an increase in older mums. All the data shows that the older age of mother at the time of birth will lead to an increased caesarean section rate. The other big changes are the increase in obesity and the increase in diabetes. But I think the really important thing that's often forgotten is that women are becoming more risk averse. If the risk of something going wrong could be avoided by caesarean section, then they're very keen on doing the best possible thing for their baby.
Jessica Claver fell pregnant with her first child 3 years ago. Despite being healthy, she elected to have a scheduled caesarean.
One of my main concerns was wanting to maintain my vaginal integrity. I didn't want to have any stitches, I didn't want to have any tears, and I didn't want to have any complications down the track. It certainly wasn't a contract that I had to uphold. I had the freedom to change my mind up until the night before, and at no point was I pressured by my doctor to do so.
Very few women actually want a caesarean section. The majority of women who end up with a caesarean section didn't want it. There's no doubt that women are feeling bullied and coerced into caesareans. It's about not giving women the full information. It's about moving them towards a direction that you want them to take.
Private hospitals have a higher caesarean section rate than public hospitals. 43% of women in private hospitals give birth by caesarean section, compared with 30% in public hospitals.
You have an obstetrician who's going to have a caseload of 300 women going through his practice or her practice in a year. There's going to be an incentive to encourage Monday to Friday, 9 to 5, scheduled births. While there's not a direct financial incentive, there's an indirect one, which enables you to have more women through your practice if you can schedule them within reasonable business hours.
The suggestion that obstetricians may perform caesarean sections for personal convenience it's just completely wrong. A caesarean section involves a whole lot of work for the obstetrician. There's more time in hospital afterwards for the mother. A vaginal birth can be the most straightforward thing for the obstetrician or midwife. The caesarean section is about the safest mode of birth for both her and her baby.
Bryony Garlick says she had an unwanted caesarean despite being told she would be supported in a natural birth by her obstetrician.
I wasn't given other options, despite the fact that my baby and myself were both entirely healthy at 38 weeks. The baby was head down facing my left hip, which is not ideal for giving birth. She raised this with an attitude like the V-back idea is over now, we're going to have to go for a caesarean. The reason for me consenting to the procedure was my own questioning of whether my body was able to give birth naturally. I left the surgery feeling desperately sad, like I'd failed again. I suffered from postnatal depression. Only recently am I starting to feel that that's lifting.
If you look at over the last 10 to 15 years in Australia, when the caesarean section rate has virtually doubled, there has been absolutely no change in the maternal mortality, and there's been no change in the numbers of babies dying. The real reason is the obstetrician is trained for 6 years to be a surgeon. All they do in their training is deal with problems. They come out of their training and you now say, here's a healthy, well woman. It's very hard for them to see that woman as not a potential problem.
Sarah Tapp says she was induced when she was 3 days past her due date, which led to a cascade of intervention resulting in an unnecessary caesarean section.
towards the end of the pregnancy, I was really tired and really uncomfortable. I sort of went, I'm so over this, you know. And he said, well, that's fine, we'll induce you. That is one of the things about private care. You're paying for a service, and a lot of obstetricians feel that their job is to facilitate what their women want. Maybe if somebody, when I sort of said, I want this baby out, and he had said, your baby will come when your baby is ready, and if we induce you, you have a higher risk of having a caesarean. None of that was mentioned. There's an obligation for your care providers to make sure that the decision you're making is informed.
Who's that?
I never had an unwell baby. I was never unwell myself. So why did I have a caesarean? My birth is very typical cascade of interventions. You start interfering, and then because you've artificially made very painful contractions that aren't doing anything, I need more pain relief, and then it ends up leading to a Caesar. I just felt steamrolled. I was a 19-year-old in the prime of my life, and here I was leaving the hospital with a giant scar on my uterus and not able to feed my baby.
It's very disappointing if some women are disappointed about their experiences around birth. You need to be psychologically prepared that the health providers might recommend, we didn't think this was going to happen, but your baby isn't tolerating labour as well as we thought it would, and you need a caesarean section. And there isn't time to have a two-hour discussion about the pros and cons of caesarean section and why at that particular point in time you felt the baby was unwell.
We can't say caesarean causes this, but we can say there's a strong association with caesarean. Type 1 diabetes is increased by 23%. Asthma and allergies are increased in babies born by caesarean by about 24-25%.
There's considerable doubt about that association, but it is interesting and it's worthy of exploration.
There are no conclusive studies that directly link caesarean sections to long-term health outcomes for children.
In this country, women have the choice, and so I'm definitely pro-choice. I feel very fortunate that this is a choice that I was able to make for myself and for my family and my son.
The biggest problem occurs when you have a woman who really wants a normal birth, and she's with, for example, an obstetrician whose caesarean section rate is 90%, but she doesn't know that. And this has been my argument for a long time. Let's get obstetricians to declare their caesarean section rates so women can truly be informed. If you want a section, go to the one with 90%. If you don't want a caesarean section, go find yourself a birth centre or midwife group practice where your chances of having a normal birth are really high.
Each individual should be making the decisions around their birth based on good information, and a policy of reducing caesarean section rate isn't a helpful one.